All right, hi, this is Lee McComas back in the studio for lesson 8. We've gotten to the end of our portrait quilt project. Now I have my portrait quilt of Maya here on the cutting mat, and I am just squaring her up, and I thought we could spend a little time and talk about getting a new blade and talk about ways to finish it. So let me line this up one more time. And I'm gonna cut that off so it's nice and neat and square again with the blade. All right. I'm sure that most of you are familiar or have your favorite technique for finishing or for binding. If you feel like you need a refresher, both Alex and Ricky have done demos on finishing techniques. So if you check out show number 211, you'll see Alex doing a demo, and then Ricky's done one in show 310. And it's a great place to go and review if you feel like you need that. I wanted to talk about a couple of things. If you're giving this as a gift, oftentimes people want to hang it on a wall. And a couple of my favorite things to do are take it over on the back. This is real simple. Take a couple of scraps. These are 3-inch squares that I've got. I'm going to fold them in half, and just match them up with the top corner. Put a pin in here. Actually, I'm going to put a pin in here. Okay. I'm going to pin a pin up here. And then I'm going to put this one over on the other side. The great thing about this is all it takes to hang this after, you know, you put a binding, or you can, you know, pillowcase it or face it. All you need to do when you've got it done is take a dowel rod and you can hook it in the corners and you can hang it by that. It'll hang on a nail. Another favorite thing I like to do, let me get these out of the way. This was the one I did of the blue boy. And I put a sleeve on the top of it. It matches the background fabric. So I'm gonna stick a bar in here. And I cut down the top in the very center, and I fold it back and I stitch up and down and I create this V. And then you've got a couple of options. You can cut your board to the right length, and you can drill a hole here and here, and you can hang it off of two nails, and that's really stable. But this piece is pretty small, and it doesn't take much to keep it on the wall and keep it stable. You have the option of putting a hole right here in the middle and then hanging it on one nail. So cut that board off so it matches. So those are a couple ideas. You may have others. Talk to your quilt friends. Everybody's got their favorite finishing technique. And then again, post your portraits because we want to see these finished pieces. If you'd like to see more of the work that I do, you can go to my website. It's leemccomas.com. See some of the other portrait quilts that I do. I like to do oftentimes a lot of heavy thread painting and thread stitching, and I'd love to share that with you. I offer some classes. I do this portrait class, and we cover, you know, some other little things in detail. I can also do a more advanced class where we work with varied color schemes, 2, 3 or more colors in one portrait piece, and we work in larger format. So if you're interested in any of that, please just go check out my website. It tells you how to get in touch with me if you want more information. Love to hear from you. And of course, post your finished project. We'll be doing the drawing for one person who will send me a photo, and I will create a portrait quilt just for them. Oh, and you know, before I leave, one more thought. They don't always come to me in order. Another great gift idea. I had a student, Mary Havens. She took my class and she did a portrait quilt of her granddaughter, Allie. And she gave this quilt to her daughter, the mother of Allie, who was so thrilled with it, she showed it around. And then Mary got feedback. I don't know if this is good or bad. Her husband, the father of Allie, loved the piece and wanted one for himself. Allie's other grandparents saw the piece and they wanted one. And of course, Mary decided this was a really great portrait piece and she'd like to have one too. She didn't feel like making 3 more quilts of the same thing. She took her original quilt to a photo processing lab. They scanned it and printed it onto canvas and then stretched her quilt onto stretcher bars. So she ended up with one actual portrait quilt and 3 stretch canvases that looked exactly like her portrait quilt. So if you would rather spend the money than the time, that's another option for you. And again, let us know if you've done that or if you come up with other ideas for how to share your portrait work